Welcome to chemistry class with Flash Isaac. Today we'll be solving this question. And don't forget to subscribe if you find this video helpful. This question says, a mixture of sugar and sulfur can be separated by. Remember, mixture contains elements and elements, or elements and compound, or compound and compounds combined physically. So this means that there is no physical, there is no chemical reaction involved in the formation of mixture. So this is the opposite of compounds. So examples of mixtures are sand and water. So anything you can mix together, even air, is a mixture. Now look at it. We are in this situation. We have sugar and sulfur. Which of the following options best explains the way we can separate them? Looking at this, sugar dissolves in water readily. Sulfur is insoluble in water. Now, what do we do? If we dissolve, which is a dissolution in water, sugar will dissolve in water, remaining sulfur. So we can take sulfur out of it, which is a dissolution in water, and filtration. So because once you dissolve in water and sugar dissolves, it will be left with sulfur. So by the time you filter, water will leave, you are left with sulfur. Now you have sulfur, you are left with water and sugar. So how do we separate water and sugar? To separate water and sugar, we simply heat, evaporate, so that the water evaporates, leaving behind the sugar. Evaporation first is obviously wrong. So the correct option is, you dissolve in water, sugar dissolves, then you filter to get your sulfur. After that, evaporation is used to separate water and sugar. So that is how you separate this mixture. Thanks for watching, and feel free to subscribe to this channel. And don't forget to check out my other videos, because there are a lot of videos that you find very helpful there. Thank you.